Hey everyone, welcome back. iPadOS 16.1 is out. Have you updated your iPad to iPadOS 16.1? It's pretty awesome. I love the Stage Manager feature. It's very useful, making my work more efficient. But after updating to iPadOS 16.1, my iPad was stuck on the black screen for no reason. I don't know why, so I check it out. I find out 4 ways you should try on if you have the same issue on your iPad. Let's go. Before we start, you need to make sure that your iPad black screen is not caused by a hardware issue. If it is, then all you can do is look for Apple support. First way, fix iPad black screen with ReiBoot. This is an iOS system repair tool. It can fix more than 150 iOS issues. So I recommend you try this first. Check the download link in the description if you are interested. Once installed, connect your iPad to your PC or Mac and open ReiBoot. Click the green Start button and choose Standard Repair. Here will require to download firmware to fix iPad black screen issue. Click it. The download won't be long, depending on your network condition. Once download is OK, click Start Standard Repair. ReiBoot will start to fix your iPad black screen of death issue. Be patient. It will be done very soon. Then you can see, my iPad is back to its normal state again. I can access it without any problem, and all my data is still there. Go try it. If you don't want to fix your iPad with the software yet, try the next method. Second way, force restart iPad. When there are a bug occurs on your Apple device, you should try to force restart. So press the home button and press the power button and keep pressing till the Apple logo appears. For the iPad without a home button, press the volume up and press the volume down, then press and hold the power button. Keep pressing till the Apple logo appears. If everything goes right, your iPad should be okay again. If it is not, follow the next method. Third way, fix iPad black screen with iTunes or Finder. To fix your iPad with iTunes, you need to connect your iPad to your PC or Mac and open iTunes or Finder. I will use iTunes here, and then put your iPad in recovery mode. Press and hold both the power button and home button. Keep holding till the recovery mode screen shows up. For iPad without a home button, press the volume up and press the volume down. Then press and hold the power button. Keep holding till the recovery mode screen shows up. If your iPad didn't show anything, don't worry, just check iTunes or Finder. You should see it pop up a window. We need to choose Update here. Then iTunes or Finder will begin to download the firmware that is needed. When the download is okay, it will start updating your iPad. Because these two processes take me a long time, so I will skip them. If you don't want to waste much time, still recommend you try first way. Fourth way, charge your iPad. There are some of the people who don't know their iPad ran out of power. They think the iPad is broken, and they keep trying to turn it on but they can't. But it is not broken, it might just run out of power. Just charge your iPad for about 20 minutes. Make sure it has enough power. Then try to turn it on. If it can turn on, it means your iPad is good. If it is not, you should try the first, second, and third ways. Okay, that's it. Hope this video is helpful to you. I will be grateful if you subscribe. See you guys next time.